Hello, everyone. Welcome to today's racing news. And the countdown is well and truly underway now to Saturday's $5 million Caulfield Cup in Melbourne. The barrier draw has been done. And for most of the favourites, they've come up with good draws. And the market really hasn't altered a lot. Kings Will Dream, who got the slot in the Caulfield Cup by winning the Mornington Cup, has come up with barrier six and is right now the outright favourite. Young Star draws 10. The Cliffs of Moher, 3. Homesman, 4. And Ace High, who's an $11 chance for David Payne, remained at that price after coming up with barrier 8. The horses that have drifted out in the markets due to wide draws are Best Solution for Godolphin and Night's Watch after coming up with barrier 18. Also drawing out wide is the German horse, now trained by Mike Maroney in Soundcheck. It's come up with barrier 16. It's got form, good form around Best Solution, and it worked yesterday for jockey Jordan Childs.
Happy with the way he worked, and Jordan thought that he that work would bring him on. So, you know, he's a horse that we don't know a lot about, hard to get a handle on, but certainly if he can take his form from Europe here, he's right in it.
So 4:40 Melbourne time is Caulfield Cup time there on Saturday afternoon. We move now to the Cox Plate, and the Kiwi-trained Savvy Coop is on the way to Melbourne for the race. The trainer Michael Pittman went through a 7.5-hour operation late last week and another operation on Monday for cancer. He's hoping to be at Moonee Valley in Saturday week for the race. Now, Savvy Coop we saw back in the championships this year in Sydney. Here she is winning the Group 1 Liverpool Mole Classic. The mare is on the way, as they say, with a stopover tonight in Sydney, then to Melbourne tomorrow. Chris Johnson, who has ridden for Michael Pittman for more than 30 years, will maintain the ride in the Cox Plate. She's a Group 1 winning mare, but she's still got to take on the champion mare Winx in the Cox Plate. Well, the Tab Everest might be over for another year, but already the Australian Turf Club are looking towards the championships in April. James Ross, their racing manager, is already in England. He'll be attending Champions Race Day at Ascot on Saturday night our time. He's hoping to start talking to trainers about bringing horses to race during the championships in April. He's already got some positive reactions, so he's starting to already build momentum towards knowing names later on this month. To Randwick on Saturday now, and it's a heavy 8 at this stage for Brian Crowley and City Tats Day. This Brian Crowley, gee, it's a really competitive market. Diplomatico is the favourite. Brenton Abdullah was going to ride, but he's injured a knee and won't ride till next Wednesday, so Kobe Jennings gets the ride on Diplomatico. Roosevelt was a very impressive winner last time around, to be ridden by Rachel King. Some question mark over Jonker and Ronstar. It'll both come down to track conditions come Saturday morning. Gary Portelli has a really nice debuting two-year-old on Saturday at Randwick called Time to Rain. A half to She Will Rain under the same ownership of Derby Racing. Here he is, winning a barrier trial recently. Very quick out of the barriers. That was one thing that came through this trial. The family handle soft, certainly She Will Rain did, and I know Gary Portelli and Rachel King very keen to get time to the races there on Saturday in the two-year-old race. And with some news around this morning relevant to the Kennedy Oaks, the Group 1 at Flemington in a few weeks' time, the market has changed a little bit. These are the current prices, and it altered because Uhud is now going to the Meyer Classic. El Dorado Dreaming is unlikely to go to the Oaks, instead going to Moonee Valley on Cox Plate Day. And also for Chris Lee's Frankly Awesome, they've decided to spell after her last run. So that's the new market now, with those three horses now not going to the Kennedy Oaks. Of course, social media, it's active through Sky. All our pages are there. Some updates also on Redkirk Warrior out and about heading towards the Darley Classic. For the meantime, though, that's the Sky Racing News.